News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. I'm Dan, and joining me today is Catherine. Hi, Catherine.
Hello, Dan, and hello, everybody.
What a fantastic jumper you're wearing.
Thank you.
Very colourful. Very you. Nice. Right, what's the story?
We're looking at data privacy today, something really important for all of us these days.
OK, let's hear more from this BBC World Service news report.
Australia's consumer watchdog has filed a lawsuit against the tech company Google, accusing it of misleading customers about its collection and use of personal data. The commission said that Google collected and used the personal information of Android phone and tablet users without giving them a proper choice.
So, Google is being taken to court by the Australian Competition and Consumer Commission, that's the ACCC. Now, they're saying that Google collected and used personal data of Android users without fully asking their permission. Now, the ACCC says that consumers were informed about switching off location history, but there was another area collecting location data that users weren't informed about.
Well, we've got three words and expressions that people can use to talk about this story. What do we have for them?
Yes, we have misleading, tracking and custodian.
Misleading, tracking and custodian. OK, let's have our first headline then, please.
Let's go. We have The Guardian. Google sued by ACCC after allegedly misleading customers over location data collection.
Misleading, making someone believe something untrue or incorrect. Now, I see some word building on the horizon.
There is. This is a lovely built word with several parts to it. I'll spell the whole thing first. M-I-S-L-E-A-D-I-N-G, misleading. So let's start with the middle part, lead, the verb to lead. Now, if you lead somebody somewhere or you lead somebody to do something, you behave in a way which makes them literally walk in a certain direction.
Yeah, you direct them one way, don't
yes.
you?
Yes. So if you're in a new building and you're looking for the loo, you say to somebody, can you show me where the bathroom is? If they say, follow me, they lead you to the bathroom. Mm. So you can physically lead somebody by taking them to a particular place. Or you can, a second way we use the word lead, to lead somebody means to make them believe something. So you can lead somebody to believe that something is true.
Yeah, it's like reaching a conclusion when you, I don't know, let's say you see a page full of mathematical figures and you say, it leads me to believe.
Yeah.
And then you reach a conclusion.
Exactly. A conclusion based on evidence. The evidence that's presented leads you to a belief or a conclusion.
So what about the miss part?
Well, as we know, the miss at the beginning, M-I-S, we use miss often to mean not or wrongly or badly. So you've got words like misunderstanding. You've got...
Mishear.
Mishear, yes.
Misspoke.
Exactly. All these words that mean so you did something wrong or badly. So if you mislead somebody, you make them believe something that isn't true.
Yeah, like I did at a station, some time ago, somebody came up and asked me for directions and I got confused and I told them to go the complete wrong way.
Oh no.
I misled them, but it wasn't on purpose.
How did you feel afterwards?
Well, when I realised what I'd done, and put my hands on my head, but they'd gone and it was too late.
Oh,
there's
dear.
Nothing I could do about it.
So you misled them by accident.
That's right.
You can mislead people to believe things and it's a complete accident. You don't mean to do it. Or you can mislead somebody deliberately, on purpose. Mm. And we often use mislead in this context to say that somebody was misled.
And that's a passive, isn't it?
We do use mislead in the passive quite a lot. And the ACCC are saying that Google misled customers deliberately. They're saying
see.
It was an intentional misleading action.
And do we have any prepositions or connecting words? How do we use this mislead in a sentence?
You can mislead somebody about something.
Mm-hmm. So Google misled users about their data.
Exactly, that's what they're saying. Or you can mislead somebody into doing something. Like you misled this poor tourist.
The poor person.
Into going the wrong, completely wrong direction and probably ruined their day in the process.
If you're out there and you're watching, I am sincerely sorry. I didn't mean to do it. I was trying to be helpful.
Oh, dear.
Please forgive me. Well, thank you very much for not misleading us about this information. And let's go to our second headline.
OK, so we're looking at The Age now, and ACCC's Rod Sims is tracking Google, tracking us, and the world's watching.
Tracking, following and observing the status of something. Now, I thought that this was something to do with hunting.
Well, tracking, T-R-A-C-K-I-N-G, if we look at the verb that makes up this noun, track. If you track something, you follow it, not because you can see it, but there is evidence of where it has been. So a tracker dog can find a person just by smelling. It can follow the smell. Mm. Somebody who can track things often goes into, we think of them as being out in the wild, natural, a jungle or a desert or something, and the person looks for signs, maybe footprints, maybe broken branches, some sort of disturbance, so you can see where that person was and you follow them. You track them by the signs of where they have been.
So does this mean that Rod Sims is following Google in the forest?
Well, no, Dad, it doesn't mean that.
Okay.
But it does mean that Rod Sims is looking for evidence of what Google's actions have been.
Okay.
He's watching them. He's taking data. I don't know how he's doing it exactly, mm-hmm. but he is looking at the evidence to find out what their activities have been and still are.
So monitoring them then?
Monitoring is a really good synonym for tracking, yes.
Okay. So what kind of things can we track apart from Google?
Well, we can track lots of different things in lots of different senses. So in a business sense, we often have charts and graphs that track the progress of stocks and shares, investments. Mm. You look for that line going up, hopefully. If it goes up, it's you're tracking the progress of your shares, which is good. If the line's going down,
not so good. Yeah.
You can track students' progress in education. You can get a report that says this is how the scores went this year or this term. You can track the progress of people in a scientific study.
Hmm.
There's lots of ways. It means to follow progress by looking at the evidence and
course,
recording it.
We will be tracking the viewers of this program after we put
we
it out, won't
we? Will, yes. We'll go onto all our tracking platforms and we'll look at the data of how many people clicked like and did you share it and did you do comments.
Yeah.
So please do it because we're going to be tracking
and
we want to see that nice line going up and up and up.
Thank you very much, and thank you for keeping us on track with that information. Now, let's go to our third and final headline. But before we do, if you enjoy listening to news stories about tech companies or data privacy issues, then we have an old news review just for you, don't we, Catherine?
We do, and the headline for this one is Apple to hinder Facebook web tracking. It's from last year. It's cool vocabulary in it, another tracking story. So just click the link and you'll go straight to it.
Thank you very much. This is News Review from BBC Learning English. Now, let's go to our third and final headline.
Yes. So finally, The Australian. ACCC case shows why Google is not a trustworthy custodian of our data. Now, that's an opinion piece from The Australian.
Custodian, protector and carer of something.
Yes.
I was just going to say, it's a lovely word. It's one of my favourite words.
It's a great word. Lovely. It's a brilliant word. So let's do the spelling. C-U-S-T-O-D-I-A-N. Custodian. Comes from the noun custody.
That's the yellow sauce that we put on cake, right? Custard.
That would be lovely. The yellow sweet sauce that you have.
Imagine there was a man in charge of the custard.
The custard.
That would be wonderful.
The custodian of custard.
Yes.
No, it's not that, unfortunately. Oh. Similar sounding, but completely different.
Oh.
If you have custody of something, and those are the words that you use, have custody of something, it is with you and you protect it, you look after it, you keep it safe, and you have a legal and moral responsibility for that thing. Now, we often use this for children In children who have who aren't with their parents or can't be with both parents.
In the case of a separation or a divorce.
It can be various reasons. And the child, a court will award custody of that child to a particular person, or sometimes you can share custody. And it means that that person named by the court is responsible for the welfare, the safety, where that child lives, everything that is custody means responsibility for something's safety. So the person who has custody is the custodian.
Ah, I see. Okay, so the custodian takes care of things, or, I mean, people, obviously, in this case, a child. But what other things can we talk about in terms of custodians?
There are so many things that you can be a custodian of. And sometimes a custodian is a person. Sometimes it can be an organisation. So you can have things like the National Trust in the UK is a custodian of castles, museums, big old houses.
Estates. They've got some very nice properties.
They've got some fabulous properties, yes. So you can be a custodian of a place. You can be a custodian of things like investments, like art collections, like natural places. You can be a custodian of ideals, morals, principles.
Ah.
We can think of the police or some religions being custodians of certain ideas and values.
Now, can we recap the vocabulary, please?
We can. We had misleading, making someone believe something untrue or incorrect. We had tracking, following and observing the status of something. And we had custodian, protector and carer of something.
Thanks very much. Now, test yourself on today's vocabulary on our website, bbclearningenglish.com. We're all over social media, so YouTube, Twitter, Facebook and Instagram. And of course, our app, free to download and free to use. Thank you for joining us and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Hi, everyone. We hope you enjoyed that video and thank you very much for watching. We have so many more just like it. So if you don't want to miss a single one, make sure to subscribe and we will see you regularly. Hope to see you soon. Bye, guys.